done before. The chosen come with shining hopes to burn the Herald's lore. And every year the Herald's sigh and give the same advice. All those who would hold magic's power must then pay magic's price. Oh, there was danger in the north, that's all that Vanyel knew. An enemy of power dark sought Heralds up and slew. But only those with magic's gift were slain by silent rage. Till Vanyel of them all was left the only Herald mage. Yes, from the north the danger came beyond the border bar. The forest did not stay dark death, nor did the mountains bar. And Vanyel cried, we die, my liege, and know not why no more. So send me north, my king, that I may find the answers there. Then north went Vanyel, not alone, though 'twas of little aid. A bard was like to be to him, and Stephen was afraid. He feared that he would fail the quest, a burden proved to be. Dare not let Vanyel go alone to face dark sorcery. So out beyond the border there, beyond the border tall, into the mountains deep they went, that stood an icy wall. To find the wide cracked, and found there was a passage new, a path clean cut that winding ran, a level course and true. This path was wrought by magecraft, Vanyel knew that when he saw the mountains hewn by power alone, a part he felt withal. But to what purpose? Something moved beyond them on the trail. They watched and hid, and what have they found there turned them cold and pale. An army moved in single file by magic cloak and hid. An army moved on Valdemar that marched as they were bid. A darker force than weaponry controlled the man in place. Oh, Vanyel looked, and Vanyel knew an ancient evil's face. Then Vanyel turned to Stephen, and he told the bard to ride. To warn the folk of Valdemar, they call me Magic's Pride. It's time I earned that name, now go, I'll hold this army back. Until the arms of Valdemar can counter their attack. So Stephen rode, and so it is, no living tongue can tell. How Vanyel fought, nor what he wrought, nor how the Herald fell. The army came, but not in time to save the Herald mage. Were scorched and cracked by magic power's rage. They fought the dark ones back, although they came on wave by wave. No trace they found of Vanyel nor of his companion brave. They hardly found the focus stone, the gift of Stephen's hand, now blackened, burned, and shattered by the power that saved their land. They only found the foeman who into the woods had fled. And each one by unseen, uncanny powers now lay dead. As if the forest had somehow bestirred itself that day, had Vanyel with his dying breath commanded trees to slay. And still the forest of our north guards Valdemar from harm, for Vanyel's dying curse is stronger far than mortal arm. And every year the chosen come, despite the old advice, those who would be magic's pride must then pay magic's price.